The office, unfortunately, the person that I need to speak to more specifically is in a lecture at the moment, another lecture that's running. But I will say tentatively we'll be cancelling the workshop until further notice, unless more money is made available for it. And if it's not, then we won't go ahead with it. And if it is, then you might still be open to it. We're also having a staff meeting tomorrow morning where I can further discuss it with the rest of the staff and see if there really is nothing more that can be done to salvage that. But if it cannot, if no extra money is available, then we'll just have to cancel it.
I think when it's cancelled, I'd like you to actually give a reason for the cancellation of that lack of funding. Mm. I'd like that to be made public. I mean,
I've said it already. I mean, I think everyone.
And then I think what we will favorably consider the performance aspect of it for the 2,000 rand each. The 2 hours is too long for a performance, just in terms of simple logistics, like. People don't concentrate. An audience doesn't concentrate for 2 hours. You know, 45 minutes, you're getting close to the end. You know, people get tired. They lose concentration. They want to focus something else now. Mm. You know, so a performance is usually 45 minutes on average.
Okay.
You know, so then for that 2,000 rand, that is a performance. The 2,000 rand includes us getting there on time. The 2,000 rand includes a kind of a little rehearsal between the three of us beforehand, and the 2,000 rand includes the performance, and the 2,000 rand includes getting us back home afterwards. So in other words, it's time, you know, it's all time. That's how we calculate the time.
Moving along, I think quite a interesting, fruitful conversation.
I would say even the fact that we agreed in principle for the event to be publicized without going into detail is something that for me was done in good faith, you know what I mean? That things would happen and that there would be a reasonable sense of valuing what this is. Because if arts organizers can't value things for what it is, then it's problematic in that. So you do it in good faith. You don't imagine that a pie would undervalue a performance by local indigenous artists by implication of inviting them, you create value, but you undermine the very value by just, you put it there, then you shoot it out. Mm-hmm. But assuming that would not have happened like that, it is in good faith that I, for instance, because I mean, normally you wouldn't do that, right? You wouldn't say Koi Connections presenting a workshop, making and playing thing, when you know this is not actually tied down. The possibility exists that it might not happen. Like you and I say, so now it's being pulled. For what reason? Is it something to do with Koi Connection or with the three individuals or what? I would agree that if this thing is pulled and something is put there, it should clearly say that it's, I mean, we would do it, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the problem is not us, so it must, we must be clear in the implication of the cancellation to say, due to insufficient funds, this workshop can't happen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it doesn't need to.
But it's cool, it's got a nice ring to it. Insufficient funds. It's like, don't you think that's the poetry of South Africa? One of the insufficient funds. And yet we're sitting with billionaires.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
With guns.
in my requests, you know, to you. But I'm prepared to cut out, as I said, whatever needs to be cut out. If we need to scrap the workshop completely, you know, if a press release needs to be sent out specifically stating whatever, for whatever reasons, I'm prepared to do that.
Nice.
And then let's just focus then on the performance, and then after the meeting tomorrow, if anything changes regarding money that could be made available for the workshop, I will let you know. But let's tentatively say that if it doesn't, that we're just going to scrap it.
Yeah.
Okay, now I understand and I respect your response, and generally I think it's not just you, everybody on this team has felt, including me, that this whole thing was really rushed, and that not enough time was actually given to the project management of it because it was so rushed.
You see, that's interesting for me. You know, even just the way you describe it now, there's enough material that you've just said now describing the project, right? For it to be a metaphor, right, for how artists and the art, the environment locally is struggling. It's all along those lines and for those reasons, you know. And that's why, for me, saying that the workshop is not going to happen because of insufficient funds is a political statement. It's a positive thing. It's going to put an image in people's mind that the condition of the artist has not changed since 1994. It's getting worse, actually. And in a country where we have billionaires, we've created billionaires after just a couple of years, we still have no funds for stuff like this, which is considered national treasure stuff. And we're not even coming to indigenous knowledge areas now. We're not even dealing there yet, you know?
Who knows, maybe some miracle will happen and I'll be able to somehow find something somewhere, either within the organization or elsewhere. But
in principle, would you go along with the performance aspect of it?
Well, that's something that you as a group, if you agree, then we can do that. And then we'll just amend it online and apologize and try to make it clear that it's not due to any disorganization on your side, but just, yeah. So,
I mean, you can run with this in a serious way, right? This is the first, this will be the first Koi Connection performance.
Yeah.
In a few years.
Right? How long has it been, actually?
3 years.
Okay.
This is now over. Ons het hier stilgestaan, so dat hy vir my is die myn ding. En ons het dit, as kunstenaars het ons hy responsibility vir ons gemeenskap.
Ja.
Klink so vir my is het die kunst, die art environment,
ja.
Het die develop, soos, ek meen, soos ons het develop. Dinge het nog nie gemovie, ek meen, behalwe die feit dat ons gemeenskap, ons ground, ons grassroots connections het gegroei,
ja.
En die het, ek ben hoor, hy is fantastisch,
ja. Die,
maar waar een mens werk, die context waarin een mens werk as een kunstenaar,
ja.
Is nog nie daar nie meer.
Ons het nog geleden dat my mense geen gates moest doen, om te sê, die stekers kook nie, ons is eindelijk een defiance die die structure.
Sien jy nou, as jy dit so stel, dan sit jy die responsibility op ons. Die mense het ook die responsibility om te weet wie is daar in die kunstwereld.
Ja.
Wat beteken hy? Wat beteken hulle? En so aan, en so aan, en so aan. Voor my was ons altijd in die situation waar die responsibility is op ons, op die kunstenaar, om uit te reik. Terwyl, dit maak nie sin vir my nie. Een kunstenaar moet my sy kunstwerk doen. Jy moet nie worry oor ander goede.
Die administrateurs moet weet wie is in die land, wie is op die, who's on the block, who's doing what, in connection with what now, right?
Yeah.
Ideally. It's like, the other day somebody said, hey, we could have an event, ons moet keer poets. Who knows poets who speak to union issues? David, nie man. Of for representativity, slaan ons maar wel heel kap op. Right? Mensen komen en zeggen, hey, we must have something indigenous. Okay, who we got? Okay, we got jambies, we got marimbas, we got what, what? Maar waar is die kaapse mens aan? Weer, in die moe, so now you search for representativity. Waar is die brein mense van die indigenous mense van die kaap dan nou gerepresent in, op die program? En nou flip jy hier rond om te gaan soek en te revive, te resuscitate en te wat wat. Want, sy kan die responsibility vat om te, om te praat van development week wat sy gedoen het vir die afgelope wat, 10, 5, whatever jaar. Right? So nobody's developing shit. They would rather resuscitate en whatever, right? So vir my, direct moet aangaan in die tussentijd. No? Teachers, hou nou die teaching skills, learners get ready to learn en daar gaan sy aan.
Ja, die wie campus gebeur, die kon connection moet leren, ook op die campus moet sy presence gaan. Wat is nie een presence die in terms van simples wees die waar, hoe vind die mense nou baie beskaap dat die simples?
Kijk, wat ek, oké, okay, ek sou sê, wat ek doen, wat sy doen, wat sy doen, in die tussentijd is nog die enigste entiteite wat goed is daar nie, in die publieke oog sit, consciously, met a purpose. In ander woorde, ek gaat nou sê, Mikey, ek gaan jou een company op opbouw. Nou, ek haal nie, ek sê nie, gaat ek nou die beda gebruik, of ek ta gebruik, nee. Die bouw gaan uit dan mis, want die is op die publieke oog. En dat is die project. Right?
As een mens praat van die boog of enigens, of die boog is ons nou die klassie symbool, right? Die is ons nou die metafoor, right? As een instrument, as een symbool. Ek het nou die punt bereik, want die is my indigenous knowledge, man. Ek kan ons nou nie net my indigenous, omdat ek desperate is vir geld, my indigenous knowledge net so verkoop vir enige om die Tom, Dick en Harry, wat nou net iets niets wil doen.
So, daar is, ek dink nie, dat is baie honger wat hy doen nie, maar ek dink in die tussentijd, wanneer jy nou praat oor UWC, you know, en die presence hier in Bedo, die, ek dink, al hoe meer, daar is een story wat met jou aantrap, of het een story van die boog, of een story van die kooi mense, of wat ook al is. Die story moet een inleiding, een body van wat ewe, en dan het hy een uitleiding en een einde. Wat ewe storyline of klanklijn of wat ewe die dan naartoe, die moet die kooi connection project wees.